Hello and welcome to homework 8.02. All right, 8.01 was all about adding and subtracting. 8.02 is all about multiplication and division. Okay, so let's take a look at what we have here. First one is multiplying 5a squared by negative 5a. So when we're doing these, what we're going to do is we're going to take the numbers and we're going to multiply those, and then we're going to take the letters and multiply those. So 5 times negative 5 is negative 25. Now, when we're multiplying the letters, the rule for that is that we add the exponents. So this is a squared. This is a to the first. You can draw on that 1 there if it helps you. So a squared times a to the first, what you're really doing there is 2 plus 1, and you're getting a to the third. All right, let's take a look at number 2 here. 3a squared b to the second power. Well, that's really 3a squared b times 3a squared b. All right, when we square something, we're just multiplying it by itself. So this would be the long way of writing that out. 3a squared b times 3a squared b. And then we would just do the same thing that we did on the last problem. 3 times 3 is 9. A squared times a squared. Again, when we multiply letters, we add the exponents. So 2 plus 2 would make this a to the fourth. And then the same thing for the b's here. This is b to the first times b to the first. So 1 plus 1 is 2. So we write that as b squared. Let's take a look here. We've got a little distribution, but we're still doing multiplication. So this is 6x times 3x. So the 6 times the 3 is going to give us an 18. And then with the x to the first times the x to the first, again, we add the exponents. So 1 plus 1 is going to give us x to the second. And then when we do the second piece here, we do the 6 times the negative 4 and get negative 24. And since there's nothing to multiply this x to the first by, it just kind of comes along for the ride, all right? We don't have to, like, change it. It just stays in x to the first because there were no other x's here to multiply it by. All right. Number 4 is even easier because there's no letter on the outside. So it's just negative 6 times x, which is negative 6x. And it's negative 6 times positive 4. So that's going to give us a negative 24. All right, that's the kind of distribution we've been doing all year long. All right. Number 5 is kind of like what we saw in the last homework, but the front one has a positive 1 in front. The back one has a negative 1 in front. So when we multiply these out, the top one stays exactly the same. I mean, the first one stays exactly the same. Where the second one, all of the signs are going to flip because we're multiplying by that negative 1. So you get minus x squared plus 6x plus 2. All of those kind of flipped on us because we multiplied by a negative. And then we would combine our like terms. All right, the x squared and the minus x squared are actually going to cancel out. Negative 3 plus 6 is going to give us a positive 3. And then 7 plus 2 is going to give us a plus 9 there. Okay. Take a look at number 6. Again, kind of just more of this multiplication and distribution. 4 times 4 is going to give us 16. And then remember, this is an x to the first times x to the first. We add the exponents. 1 plus 1 is going to give us x squared. 4x times 3, the 4 times 3 is going to give us a 12, and then the x just kind of comes along because it has nothing to multiply with, so it's going to stay the same. Over on the other side, we've got a negative 3 times 4, so that's going to give us a minus 12, and then again, the x just comes along because it's not being multiplied by anything, so it stays the same. Then we have a negative 3 times a positive 3, which is going to give us a negative 9. Right? So if we look at this, nothing to combine with the x squared, These two can combine, and they're actually going to cancel each other out, because positive 12 minus 12 is 0, and we're just left with 16x squared minus 9. All right, these next four say find the GCF. Okay, so again, the way we're going to kind of encourage you to find the GCF in this class is just to take advantage of your calculator. So on number 7, when it says find the GCF of 56 and 70, what you can do is you can go to Math, which is right below the green alpha key. You're going to scroll over to Num, and then you can either hit the up arrow, which will bring you to choice 9, or you can like scroll all the way down to get to choice 9, or you can actually just hit the 9 key and it'll bring you right there. But either way, we want the one that says GCD. We're going to type in 56, 70, and that's going to tell us that our GCD is 14. So the greatest common factor here is 14. Right? So if we look at number 8 here, we've got 10 and 15. Now, 10 and 15 might be one that you can just do in your head, but again, it never hurts to check. So we can go to Math, Num, choice 9, 10, 15. All right, so our GCF here is 5. Now, when we have letters, what we're going to look at is the exponents, because we have an m squared and an m cubed. We always take the letter that has the smaller exponent. So out of m squared and m squared is the smaller one, so it's going to be 5m squared. All right, now number 9 here, you might be saying to yourself, well, there's no numbers here. Well, kind of technically there is, because there's a 1 here and a 1 here. So the GCF of 1 and 1 is just going to be 1. Now, do you have to write the 1? No, you don't. But if it helps you to kind of have a consistent procedure, then technically this is 1 and this is 1. So the GCF of 1 and 1 would be 1. Again, you don't have to write the 1. It's up to you. And then we look at our a's. So we have an a squared and an a cubed. A squared is smaller, so that's the one that we have to use. We have a b squared and a b cubed. Again, b squared is the smaller one, so that's the one that we have to use. All right, if we look at number 10 here, we've got 3x to the fifth, 2x to the fourth, and 8x to the sixth. Now, when there's 3, your GCF has to work for all 3. So you might be saying to yourself, well, 2 and 8, I could take a 2 out of that, but we can't take the 2 out of the 3. The largest number that we can take out of all 3 of these is just a 1. And we can do that even if on here, if we just go to our math, num, and GCD, you're going to see that. 3, 2, the largest GCF there is a 1. So that's the biggest thing that we're going to be able to use. All right, so again, our GCF would be 1 here, and then we have an x to the 5th, an x to the 4th, and an x to the 6th. We have to take the smallest of these 3, so that would be an x to the 4th. Okay. All right, let's take a look at the back. So these say factor out the GCF in each of the following expressions. So on the front, we just had to find the GCF. Now we have to find the GCF and factor it out. So let's take a look at number 11. We've got 6x squared and 36. So let's do a quick math num, choice 9, 6, 36. So our GCF there is a 6. So our GCF is 6. Now you might be asking, what about the x squared? Well, since this one doesn't have an x, we can't take out an x squared. You know, I said you always had to take out the smaller. Well, no x at all is smaller than x squared, so we can't take out an x. We're just left with taking out this 6. So that's our GCF. That's what we're going to divide by or factor out, and now we actually do the division. So both of these get divided by 6. We pull the 6 out front. That's the number that we were dividing by. And then 6 divided by 6 is 1. So that's just 1x squared. Or again, you don't have to have the 1. You can just write x squared. And then we do 36 divided by 6. which is 6. So that would be the GCF factored out of this top thing. And you'll notice that if I were to multiply these back out, I'd end up right back where I started. Right, let's take a look at number 12. So we've got 8x squared plus 24x. So the GCF here of 8 and 24 is going to be 8. Now on this one, we have an x squared and what's really an x to the first. So in this case, we pull out the smaller of those two x's, and it's 8x to the first. You don't have to write the first in there. I just find that it does help some kids. So we're going to divide both of these by 8x to the first, 8x to the first. So I'm going to write the 8x on the outside. 8 divided by 8 is 1. Now, when we're dividing variables, instead of adding the exponents, we're going to subtract the exponents. So 2 minus 1 becomes x to the first. And again, you can write the 1 in there, but both of these 1s that I've written, you don't have to have them. I could just write this as x, and it would be just as correct. All right, plus 24 divided by 8 is 3. And then again, when we divide, 1 minus 1 is 0, so it would be x to the 0 power, but anything to the 0 power is just 1, so there's no point in writing 3 times 1 here, because 3 times 1 would still be 3. So you can almost kind of think of that as the x's are sort of canceling out, because 1 minus 1 is going to give you a 0. So this would be 8x, and then parentheses, 1x to the first plus 3, or if you didn't want those 1s in there, you could just write it as 8x times x plus 3. Either one of those is fine. All right, 13, y to the 6th, y to the 4th, plus y squared. Again, even though we don't write them, all of these have a 1 in front. All right, so when we're looking at our GCF, we can think about it as 1, and then out of y to the 6th, y to the 4th, and y squared, our smallest variable is the y squared. So our GCF would be 1y squared. So we're going to divide them all by 1y squared, 1y squared, 1y squared. We can write that out front. And again, you don't have to have the 1. I could just write this as y squared. I'm going to put in my parentheses. Then 1 divided by 1 is just 1. All right, so I could write that 1 there. Y to the 6th divided by y to the 2nd. We do the 6 minus the 2, and we end up with y to the 4th plus 1. And then y to the 4th divided by y to the 2nd. 4 minus 2 is 2. So that's going to give us y to the 2nd plus 1y squared divided by 1y squared. Well, the 1 divided by 1 is going to give us a 1. And then the y squared divided by the y squared is y to the 0 power, which remember is 1, but there's no point in writing 1 times 1, so we can just leave it like that. A lot of times when kids have this, they want to just like completely cancel it out and say, oh, it's just gone. But remember, anything divided by itself is going to be 1. 7 divided by 7 is 1. 10 divided by 10 is 1. So 1y squared divided by 1y squared is just going to be 1. All right, let's take a look at 14 here. So we have 3x squared y, 18xy squared. So if we look at our GCF, the GCF of 3 and 18 is going to be 3. And then we have to look at the letters one by one. We have an x squared and an x to the first. So out of those two, x to the first is smaller. And then we have a y to the first and a y squared. So out of those two, y to the first is smaller. All right, we can divide both of these. So 3x to the first, y to the first, divide by 3x to the first, y to the first. That's going to come down out front. We're going to have our parentheses, and then let's actually do the division. 3 divided by 3 is 1. X squared divided by x to the first, we do the 2 minus the 1, and we're left with x to the first. And then on this one, we have y to the first divided by y to the first, 1 minus 1 is 0, so you can think of those as kind of canceling out. plus 18 divided by 3 is 6. X to the first divided by x to the first, 1 minus 1 is 0, so those just kind of cancel out. And then y squared divided by y to the first, 2 minus 1 is 1, so that's y to the first. All right, so you'd end up with 1x to the first plus 6y to the first. But again, those 1s don't need to be in there. You can just write it like this, and that would be totally fine. Some kids don't mind this. Some kids like having the ones in there so that they know what's going on. All right, 15. We've got 5x squared plus 15x minus 20. All right, so the GCF of 5, 15, and 20 is going to be 5. Now, there's an x squared here. There's an x to the first here. But there's no x at all. So again, it has to be for all three. So when we say what's smaller, x squared, x to the first, or no x at all, no x at all is smaller than x to the first or x squared. So our GCF is not going to have an x with it. So we're just going to divide all of these by 5. 5 comes out front. 5 divided by 5 is 1. So we have 1x squared. Plus 15 divided by 5 is going to be 3x, and then 20 divided by 5 is going to be minus 4. All right, one thing I do want to note about this one is that when you have three numbers like this, if you try to use the GCD, so if you go to math num and then you put in 5, 15, 20, you're going to get an error because you only can actually have two things when you do a GCF. So the way that you have to do it is you have to kind of do it in pairs. So you would do 5 and 15, say, all right, the GCF of that is 5, and then you would do it again, and you would use this answer. So our answer was a 5, and you would do it with whatever number you didn't use the first time. So in our case, a 20. And you're going to see in this case, it just stays 5. It won't always stay the same number, but in our case it did stay the same number, and it's just the 5 there. Alright. So let's take a look at number 16 here, and let's use this as kind of an example. So if I went to math num GCD, and the first time I decided to use 18 and 6, I would go 18, 6, and I would say, okay, I got an answer of 6. And then if I do it again and use my answer, which was 6, with the remaining number, which was 15, you're going to see that it actually goes down to a 3. So my GCF for these three numbers would be a 3, not a 6. So if I look at my GCF over here, GCF is going to be 3. And then I have to look at the letters. I have an x cubed, an x squared, and an x to the first. So the smallest one there is x to the first. And then I have a y squared, a y to the first, and a y cubed. The smallest one there is y to the first. So they're all going to get divided by that 3 x to the first, y to the first, 3 x to the first, y to the first, 3 x to the first, y to the first. All right, so that's what comes out front. I use my parentheses, and then I just do the division. 15 divided by 3 is 5. X cubed divided by x to the first, we do 3 minus 1, and we get x squared. Y squared divided by y to the first, we do 2 minus 1, and are left with a y to the first. Minus 18 divided by 3 is going to be 6. X squared divided by x to the first, 2 minus 1, is just going to leave us with an x to the first. Y to the first divided by y to the first, 1 minus 1 is 0, so those are going to just kind of cancel out, because anything to the 0 power is 1. Plus 6 divided by 3 is 2. X to the first, 1 minus 1, they're going to cancel out, because it would become x to the 0. And then y to the third divided by y to the first, 3 minus 1 is 2. So that is y squared. Close our parentheses. And that is it. All right. So I hope this was helpful and have a great day.